Hey folks, it's Phineas Goblin here, originator of the Phinarian Sword, and as the opening vlogging video, I'm going to show the full process of carving behind every sword we do nowadays. But first, we're going to go through a little bit of background. In 2013, shortly after watching the first third of The Hobbit, one of my older brothers and I were inspired to carve a sword out of a poplar log. Now, the tools we used were a hatchet, a knife, and a rasp. And the finished product was pretty crude, to be honest, to say the least. It was, however, cool enough to keep us moving. And so we made another, which was based on an elven blade this time. The first one was more of a hobbit sword. The elven blade was also quite crude, and we messed up a lot of the details we were trying to add to it. But they were also inspiring to us to get more done. And now, I think a lot of things have changed. About 4 years ago, I got on a kind of a learning streak where every sword I make would bring me closer to learning something else. And since then, it's just been great learning about all the things you can about carving these swords. And now we're using pine as well as poplar, and pine for all the swords, and then poplar for all the knives and daggers, short swords and stuff like that. Get carving. Okay, so we've finished planing, and it is a basically very flat board. The planer really works wonders for the wood, and it's a nice tool to have around, especially as it has even more uses than just flattening boards, or logs as it is. So the next part is going to be a little more tedious. We're going to take off all that and flatten it out with the hatchet and the planer. So as soon as we're finished doing that, we basically have at the board stage, which is the stage you have it before you even start adding detail. It's also an encouraging stage, seeing as you're like, well, at least I know it's even. But you know, there we are.
Okay, so
you see how bumpy this is? Maybe you can't. You see how bumpy it is? It's just really hilly. It's terrible. But the planer will solve all that and flatten most of it out. Getting that nice scraping, and it's doing its job. Start in the middle first, and then we'll gradually come up to the sides. You make one little mistake up here, you take your hand off. Okay, so this is it right here, and we've got it as flat as possible, so hopefully nothing's too uneven. It's okay if there's a little bit, I mean,
no plank of wood is perfect. So even if it's just a tiny bit off, it's not going to affect the end result that much, because everything has to be, you know, cut down completely with the measurements when I'm doing the edges and stuff like that. So it's not a big deal if it's a little off, and a little off is what we go with every time. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to sand the heck out of it. Well, not necessarily sand the heck out of it. I sand the heck out of it at the end result. But right now I sand down here, and on the other side, and then down here on the other side. I rarely, in fact I never, sand right there and the top and bottom. But once that's done, then I can start drawing the measurements for the handle, cut that out with the hatchet and sometimes the knife, and then I'll do, really depends whether the wood is thick enough or, you know, if it has some problems, whether I can do the, draw the measurements for the tip, whether it's point or tapered. And tapered is basically what we're going with every time. It's just what it sounds like. It's the tapered point comes down more gradually, whereas the hard point is just straight and then curves into a point immediately. So yeah, sometimes I'll do the measurements immediately once I've sanded it for the point, but sometimes I might wait a bit, and then yeah, it really depends.
You may notice there are no glasses or a breathe guard. You just gotta watch out for the dust.
All right, the sword is now completely sanded. And what I do next is I draw the measurements on the handle. Probably just the handle this time. I might do the tip, depending on how many difficulties get in the way. The measurements will come up to about here. So I have basically a one-handed sword with a little space at the end. And I remarked from a friend that he said they measured the swords as a hand like this. So not like this, like this. And I was like, well, you know, that makes more sense, because nobody wants to be holding way down at the bottom as a hand. So yeah, I thought that was pretty interesting. So you might just call this a one-handed sword. And that doesn't mean it's going to be way down here and I have barely any room, and the tip, like the hilt's gonna be right here. It means it's my hand all the way from over here to the tip of my fingers. And that gives me basically plenty of space. So it goes back to what I said before, it's just a one-handed sword with a little bit of room. So I'll draw the measurements there. And I'll try to keep the handle pretty thick. I don't want to have it too thin, otherwise it'll break easily. But if it's thick, it shouldn't be a problem whether it's thin or thick. But I do want to make sure the wood, if it is really does have a thin width, then I'll try to make sure that it's not too thin width wise this way.
Okay, so I finished the measurements, and this is what we got so far. You can see the outline of a handle right here.
Along here. And so what I did was I drew a line right here, then came over here and did another one, because it's a ridiculously long handle, though I say so myself. And then I drew measurements, making sure this line and this line were equal, and then this line and this line were equal, and drew these lines down. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hammer out this and this with a hatchet, and of course replicate it on the other side, and hopefully you can see down here that they do match up pretty well. Hopefully they'll kind of cascade with the same amount on each side. And if they don't, that's okay. I'll rasp it around until everything is completely circular. And then I'll start going around to make the handle completely smooth and oval. Mostly oval. Usually it's circular. But you can see here that it's going to be kind of oval. And then the only reason I drew this line is because coming down here, it's a little filthy, you know, and it's not easy to draw precise measurements, let alone good ones. And then down here, same deal. It's kind of dirty. But this line makes everything easier, and it's actually interesting to see how it can go from here to here all the way down to the end result back here. So yeah, I'll carve that out, and we'll basically have our handle in the rough draft. I say rough draft, I don't mean that. I guess I mean the prop.